Yes, Your Honor. We'd like to present a witness. I'd like to call James St. Patrick to the stand.
You swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth to help you, God?
I do.
Mr. St. Patrick, are you aware of the check the prosecution cited?
Well, yeah. I don't know where you grew up, but when somebody gives you a check for seven figures, you tend to remember that's a lot of zeros.
Can you explain the purpose of the check?
Yes, the check was a loan to pay a security firm that I hired some time back to secure my three nightclubs.
And why did you need to go to your friend, Tommy Egan, for this? I mean, you're a successful businessman. You have three nightclubs. Why not a bank?
Well, Tommy's my friend. I was in negotiations with the Bastard Hotel Group at the time. I'd invested all my liquid money with them, so I needed the immediate cash.
I'm sure that put your family in a pretty tough spot.
It did. As a father, it keeps you up at night, hoping that you're providing everything for your children. That's why I'm fighting so hard to get back to them, back home.
When Mr. Mak comes up here to question you, he's going to say that you were desperate for money. Lucky for you, your friend Tommy Egan had that money, but he did need something in return. He needed you to kill Agent Knox.
Which absolutely couldn't be further from the truth. I get it. Where I grew up, Southside Jamaica, Queens, people think as a young black man that you're given one coin with two sides, Your Honor. Death or jail. Fortunately for me, I'm living proof that it can go another way. Tommy's loan was simply that, a loan. No quid pro quo, no strings attached. I'm a businessman. I'm a husband, a father, and a friend. Nothing more, nothing less.
No further questions, Your Honor.
All right, you may step down, Mr. St. Patrick. We will take a 30-minute recess.
Mr. St. Patrick, earlier you stated that Thomas Egan was a close friend, that he'd do anything to help you in your time of need.
Within me.
In turn, you'd do anything for him, like going to Agent Knox's apartment. Right?
I didn't go to Agent Knox's apartment.
Well, your fingerprints are there. It's a rookie mistake. But after all, you're a businessman, not a contract killer. You made a deal. You had to uphold your end of the deal with your friend. You had to kill Agent Knox.
Objection, Your Honor. Badgering the witness.
Your Honor, Mr. Silver knew the risk of putting his client on the stand before he did it.
No, he's got to there, Mr. Silver, overruled.
I'm sure there was a part of you hoping you didn't have to kill him. But then you saw it. The look in his eyes when he realized why you were really there. You pulled out your gun.
Your Honor?
You hadn't committed a crime yet. You could walk away and no one would ever know. Except Knox would know, wouldn't he? He'd know what you were. Tommy Egan's henchman. A criminal. A killer.
I'm not a killer.
He didn't know what was at stake for you. Who you were protecting. Who paid for you to be there with the check we found. When Knox went for your gun, you had to shoot him. Isn't that right, Mr. St. Patrick?
I didn't shoot anyone.
And when he didn't die right away, when he held his hand out to beg you to stop, you didn't have a choice. There was no going back. In cold blood, you shot Agent Knox again. You saw his lifeless body laying on the ground and you panicked. So you climbed out the window and left your fingerprints behind. Isn't that right?
I didn't kill Agent Knox, and I repeat, I wasn't there.
But your fingerprints are in his apartment, Mr. St. Patrick. How can we believe you? Your Honor, we know what? A murder. We know who? The defendant. We know where and when, and now we know why. Because you were paid, Mr. St. Patrick. Because a good businessman always holds up his end of the deal.
I didn't kill Craig!
Your Honor, this speculative rant by the prosecution has no bearing on the matter at hand and should be stricken from the record.
No further questions, Your Honor. Although I am curious, how does the defendant know the victim well enough to call him Greg?
Your Honor.
Withdrawn.
Mr. St. Patrick, you can step down. And if the defense has no further witnesses, I will make my ruling on the check being admitted into evidence tomorrow morning. In the meantime, Mr. St. Patrick will be returned to the MCC.